Thanks so much for joining us for 9 on your side at 5. The showdown at City Hall continues tonight. We now know that Harry Black could be Cincinnati's former city manager at 5 o'clock on Wednesday. That is if council approves a separation package.
However, the majority will not buy him out, and they continue to push for an outside council to mediate this personnel issue. 9 on your side's Tom McKee is live at City Hall with where things stand now. Tom?
Well, Tanya, this is the agreement that both Harry Black, the city manager, and Mayor John Cranley signed over the weekend. The value, $423,000 in salary, medical benefits, and attorney's fees. Now, this matter is on the agenda for council this Wednesday for approval, but right now, the votes are just not there to make it official. Mayor John Cranley and city manager Harry Black both agree that $423,000 would put their public dispute in the rearview mirror. City Council's Law and Public Safety Committee approved it Monday and sent it on to the full council Wednesday. Christopher Smitherman, Jeff Pastor, Amy Murray, and David Mann give it a thumbs up.
What I don't want to do is in any way harm the city manager to try to not have him depart the city of Cincinnati with dignity, and I think that that is what is before us.
That this is no different than when a CEO leaves a major corporation. Think about P&G or Federated. I mean, these types of severance packages are negotiated all the time.
A big question is whether the dispute is hurting city operations. The answer depends on your view of the deal.
Department heads are not sure if he's staying or not, so the city is at a standstill and people are having a difficult time moving forward.
Well, I think anytime you have a situation like this, it is harmful. If you believe that somehow the city's business is not getting done, I would disagree. I haven't stopped doing my job.
Democrats Tamiya Denard, Greg Landsman, Chris Seelbach, P.G. Sittenfeld, and Wendell Young opposed the deal.
There has been a souring of a relationship. Is it then fair to go to the taxpayers and say, this relationship has had a falling out, so we want to ask you, the taxpayers, for $500,000 is the solution? I'm not just an elected leader for the city. I'm also a taxpayer, and that offends my sense of fiscal responsibility.
Well, the majority right now, they still want mediation between the manager and the mayor to try to iron things out. Councilmember Wendell Young says a mediator has been located and would do the job pro bono for free. Of course, the other side says they're still worried about the idea that that could cost more than the buyout originally. So the drama continues at City Hall with no end in sight. Tom McKee, 9 on your side, live downtown.